Since the end of World War II, a robust partnership between the United States federal government and academic research institutions has fueled countless scientific breakthroughs. This alliance, rooted in a mutual understanding of science's vital role in national security and societal progress, has kept America at the forefront of global innovation. But recent changes from the Trump administration have put that alliance at risk. What could happen if we lose the vital partnership between academia and the federal government? That's the topic of this week's Healthcare Triage. First off, I want to note that we're filming this in mid-March 2025. In recent days, government grantors from the Department of Defense to the NIH have terminated many grants that include any mention of diversity or sexual identity. Government policies and practices are changing very quickly and unpredictably right now, but we'll do our best to give you a picture of what's going on at this moment. So, central to the partnership between academia and the federal government is a social contract. A set of unwritten agreements ensuring that academia could operate free from political interference while being supported through robust federal funding. This arrangement facilitated breakthroughs in technology and healthcare, like the development of the polio vaccine and the space program, illustrating how government-backed research propelled societal advancements. The historical partnership thrived on the principle of academic freedom, allowing scholars to pursue groundbreaking research on behalf of the public without undue restrictions. But recently, new government mandates targeting diversity, equity, and inclusion programs are threatening to narrow the scope of scientific inquiry. Specifically, one executive order straight up calls for the termination of all equity-related grants and contracts. But without providing an operational definition for equity-related, or a legal or evidentiary basis justifying the exclusion of equity-related research. In other words, the order doesn't provide any explanation of why equity-related research is not important. As a result of this, there have been reports of federal agencies conducting keyword searches on NSF-funded grants to identify awards that should be considered for termination. This kind of restrictive oversight threatens the environment of academic exploration crucial for nurturing innovation. Without the freedom to pursue diverse avenues of research, the chances of making transformative discoveries diminish. Technologies like CRISPR and innovations in renewable energy might never have emerged without such freedom. Beyond this assault on academic freedom, let's look at scientific integrity, which is critical for maintaining trust and progress. Recent actions have led to the suppression of valuable data sources, endangering this foundational principle. Consider the removal of key databases, like the CDC's Behavioral Risk Factor Surveillance System, which has provided vital information for public health strategies for nearly four decades. Other important sources, like CDC Atlas Plus and Target HIV, also face similar restrictions, cutting off data that inform on national health trends and fuel life-saving research. Though some access to these datasets have been restored, there are concerns about data reliability and whether future datasets will remain unbiased and comprehensive. Accurate data is essential for drawing informed scientific conclusions. Any restriction or alteration can distort findings, leading to flawed public policies and undermining trust in scientific institutions. So we've covered academic freedom and scientific integrity, but what about the economic implications of recent federal actions? For example, a recent shift to standardize NIH indirect cost rates to 15% may sound like no big deal, but it threatens to siphon billions in support away from research institutions. Previously, these rates varied and often averaged around 27%, reflecting the diverse needs of institutions based on size, geographic location, and research focus. When it comes to research funding, costs are divided into two main buckets, direct and indirect. Think of direct costs as the salaries for lab technicians running experiments or the materials they use, like test tubes and reagents. Meanwhile, indirect costs cover everything that supports the research behind the scenes, like the lab coats the staff wears, the electricity keeping the lights on in the lab, and the IT support needed to ensure researchers' equipment is functional. It's all these behind-the-scenes essentials that keep research running smoothly. This sudden reduction in those critical behind-the-scenes essentials could lead to halted research projects, job losses, and stalled technological advancements, impacting everything from cancer research to public health innovation. Not only that, But smaller institutions, particularly those in resource-poor areas, are disproportionately affected. Hiring freezes and paused graduate admissions have already been implemented in anticipation of these funding uncertainties. The current challenges facing American science are unprecedented. Academic freedom, scientific integrity, and economic vitality are all under threat. Without a course correction, we risk losing our position as a leader in global innovation, which could have far-reaching consequences for generations to come. This isn't just me as the host of Healthcare Triage speaking. It's also me as the president and CEO of AcademyHealth. We're all dedicated to addressing these challenges head on. As the professional association representing health services and policy research, AcademyHealth is actively working to support researchers, advocate for evidence-based policy, and ensure the sustainability and integrity of scientific research. Connect with us on social media to learn more. Hey, did you enjoy this episode? You might enjoy this previous episode about reducing the costs of healthcare. We'd like it if you subscribe to the channel, maybe like the video down below, maybe go to patreon.com/healthcaretriage where you can help support the show, make it bigger and better. A big thank you to Dr. Elizabeth Cope at Academy Health, whose expert insights helped shape this episode. And of course, we'd especially like to thank our research associates, Edward Lilleholm and Joshua Crow, and of course, our surgeon admiral, Sam.